and enjoy.
Turn the volume up higher, listen, get a drink, get a snack, relax, and pay attention. We gon' talk about stats, perhaps even the Pistons. A whole lot of this and that before the finish. It's Fanarchy Detroit, you know the business. Yeah, we so terrific, yeah, we go the distance. Yeah, we smoke and shit during intermission. You mad? Blank Keys, he made those decisions. Sports Radio Detroit and CRB. Two places, same time, who are we? The best show surfing the airwaves. No matter how you chop it, any topic is fair game. Stand up and give yourself a round of applause, cause all of the stats show that we down for the cause. And long as y'all around and listen, we got a reason. It's Fanarchy for life, it's our season. Yo, this Fat Father, and when I want to talk sports, music, or anything under the sun, I'm tuned in to Fanarchy Detroit. Veterans Day in stores now. Go get that.
Mark Miles joins us today. He's promoting his song On His Way to the Top. That's going to be fun. He's always been a great part of the show. Klonica is here. Jason is here. Wilson will be here in a minute. Angie is in the third realm of hell, which is called Chuck E. Cheese. Her kid's birthday was this week, so she decided that she was going to go into the portal of hell and hang out in Chuck E. Cheese with her kid. She's got some good stories. Make sure you tune in next week because she's got some stuff that she wants to tell us about. I'm happy to see everybody here.
Don't worry, we're going to talk about the second portal of hell today, which is Charlottesville, Virginia.
Oh, yeah, we're going to talk about that. And how the Red Wings are wrapped into it.
Man, that's getting old already. Like, it's been, like, half a day, and I'm already tired of it, mostly because I'm so, like, tapped into, like, Red Wing stuff on Twitter that, like, as soon as I woke up, I'm like, oh, what's just going on Twitter? And the Red Wings are like, we are not Nazis! We do not support this! It's not us, I swear to God!
Then, like, then why did you make that photo your cover photo on Facebook?
Ooh!
What photo my cover photo on Facebook? I'm just joking. I was very... Just joking, yeah. But that would have been really, really, really wrong.
If I had been curveball, sneaky, right-wing guy.
That would
Don't they call themselves the Right Wings or something like that?
It was a Unite the Right protest.
But the reason they used the Red Wings logo was because it was the Right Wings. I think that's what they called themselves.
Does the wing point to the right?
Yeah.
Oh.
Oops.
Oops. Mm. Do you think the Red Wings are more mad about this, or were they more mad when Tupac was spitting at cops with their jersey on?
I think they're more mad about this because they actually had to like answer for this.
Well, I mean, they would have had to answer to Tupac back in the day. They would have.
Social media wasn't as big.
Social media didn't,
exist. But yeah, they would have been mad. They would have been mad if they would have had Tupac spitting at cops with their jersey on.
Yeah, maybe. I just think this is.
Oh no, this is much
bigger.
Well,
yeah.
But at least Tupac was big, and it really bumped up jersey sales in the African American community.
They
were okay with that.
I think that
they were selling jerseys.
Hockey jerseys are the only thing that you can actually wear as clothes and not be embarrassed about it.
I agree.
Baseball is
close.
Baseball
jerseys are fine.
Yeah, and
basketball is good in the summer. Football's the one that you really can't wear in any circumstance. It's got those little dainty little girly sleeves that like stop like right above your right below your armpit. And then it kind of just like flares out at the bottom because you're supposed to tuck it in.
No, they don't even flare out anymore. Now those new ones that Nike makes are... They're like skin tight.
No, so it's like wearing a fucking Under Armour with little baby girl sleeves.
Man, we're going to get into that. We have uniform watch today because NBA changed their uniforms and MLB have some special uniforms for their
I like those
players only weekend.
I got a story for those too.
Oh, do you?
Yeah, it's nothing like crazy. It's just something stupid that I found really funny.
When Wilson gets here, I want to talk about Lil Boosie. There's something that happened there. I know you don't know who Lil Boosie is, but
me and Tim were like,
I know who he is.
Me and Tim,
face.
Oh, okay. So I'll be the only one going to get sushi during that segment.
Well, no, I mean it's something real quick that we can get in and get out because it pertains to as a father, we all want our sons to hurry up and get in the fucking. Well, you're not a father, and you're not a father of a son. So, you wouldn't be able to. But like your kid.
Well, and according to the court, you're not a good father of your son. So
yeah, 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 yeah. But
Yeah, but...
See, Klonica didn't know the inside scoop on that, and he thought I was just shit-talking you for a second. No. He was like, oh, and then you were like, yeah, and he's like, oh, okay.
No, yeah.
Like, oh, we're on the same page.
Yeah, yeah. Like, oh, okay, cool, they talked about that.
Yeah, so he is just... Okay, so Keese, Keese has come to terms with it. I get it. Okay,
I'm an
cool.
impatient father who texts and drives. That's what I am.
You're very excitable.
Although, I could only say there is only one person in this room that has actually seen me get mad, and that's Tim.
Yeah.
One time.
One time. One
what
time.
Did he do?
Oh.
We did
off air.
No. I could tell this.
No,
story.
Oh, okay. Funny. Story.
We did an interview with Rhino and
Rhino the wrestler.
No, it wasn't Rhino. It was Hacksaw Jim.
It was Hacksaw Jim Duggan.
That's
and
awesome.
It was right over there in that room.
Yep. It was
he was here.
No, it was a recorded interview, and the guy who had hosted the show was like, you know, because I think I had to come in. I had to come in like randomly to do
this was a random like middle of the week deal
and I had to come in and do it, and if I produce a show and they have a big guest, the only thing I would ask is I'll come in for you, but as long as you let me get 5 minutes with the person, get a few questions in, which I think is fair.
I was also mad during this interview as well. So.
He also was mad, too, because he's a wrestling fan, but was taken over by the host and wasn't able to get anything in. And so what he did was basically he wrapped up the interview, didn't let me get the time, and I got really mad and almost flipped the table over in there. And, like, Tim had to, like, chase me down because I was really, really pissed
off. He was absolutely fuming. And then, meanwhile, I'm like, fucking bitching because I'm like, he fucking asked like 5 questions to my one, and then I'd go for a follow up question, and he'd ask a follow up question. Like, I was getting pissed too. All this, and the guy who was asking the questions didn't watch wrestling and has no clue.
Had
about
no
wrestling.
The only reason why he did those was
because Puckett.
Oh God, I'm sorry. That automatically sets everything like on a 1 to 10 scale. You're at like a 6.5 to start. So then anything else just gets you to 10 real quick.
Yeah, I also got that. I didn't get that angry, but the first time Swift and McVay was in here, and he was actually in here, the guy, the host that day, told him, okay, yeah, don't worry. He's going to be on both of our shows. Don't worry. He kept telling me that. So I did everything to set up a show around Swift and McVay, and he tried to leave, and I was like, yo, at least come on our show for 5 minutes. So he came in and was like, yo, it's Fanarchy. What's up? All right, I'm out.
Oh,
I was really mad because when I produce a show, I'll do anything for the show. But if you get a big guest, just let me get a few minutes so I can get something for my show.
Mm-hmm.
You know, because I'm not the hardcore guy that's like, you know, pay me and all this other stuff. If you miss a couple weeks, it's fine. Whatever. I do everything for the shows that I produce. Just if you get a big artist, you know, hook me up so that, you know, we can make both of our shows sound good. And that didn't happen on those particular days. So Tim is really the only person at K-Rail that's actually seen me get super steaming mad.
He was pissed. Like, he was slamming shit. Like, it was really bad.
Yeah, like a slam that door. There was
they had to rebuild that whole wall for you, too. I mean, God. Now it's all soundproofing. It's weird.
I actually was pretty worried because I had never seen him get mad. And
When the calm guy gets mad, it scares you.
Yeah.
The calm guy or the
not rational guy? Then he went to his car, and
guy.
I got really scared because I'm like, what the fuck's he coming
he
back in
with? He smoked a ton of weed, and he was fine.
I did.
I went out.
Everything was good.
I did. And I smoked some weed, and then I came back, and I was like, okay, guys, I'm really, really sorry about that. I hate people to see me mad. I hate that. So
what else we got today?
I want to talk – well, we're going to talk about Charlottesville. Mark Miles will be on at 4:30. Josh Rosen. Does anyone know who Josh Rosen is? Josh Rosen is a UCLA football player who has some things to say about football and school not having to be exclusive, how you should either be a football player or an athlete. It's going to be another one of my I hate the NCAA rants.
Oh, okay.
And
I can't wait to compare it to slavery again.
Now, it has nothing to do with slavery, but
no, I'm saying I will.
And then we can go back to some of the stuff that we didn't get into last week. Now that Tim's here, we could talk about...
We could finally ask him how his Sarahah account is going.
Oh, yeah. Shit. We want to talk about that, too.
Sarahah. Have you heard of it?
No.
No, it's an app where it's like you're... Do you want to just go into it now? Or like, what
no,
do
we
do?
Need to
save for later? Okay.
We need the time. We need the content.
Can we give him tell him what the app is, and then we can talk about it later?
If you want
to. The app is an app that allows... So say you, Tim, would post a page... This is my username, you know, MegaKlon87 or whatever it is. People can then the way the all it is people leaving anonymous comments on your page.
There's no usernames. There's no liking. There's no comments. There's no pictures or anything. It's just people leaving comments on other people that, like, so the page is a known quantity. It's a person, you know, Steve Smith, and then just a bunch of comments on that person. And we'll get into where it goes later on.
Mm. Yeah. So I want,
'cause it gets fucking nuts.
We didn't get to talk about it in the 2 weeks that we were off, and we didn't get a chance to get around to it last week. But now Tim's here. This will be able to help us even more with the Tigers made some trades. They also basically put Justin Verlander up to the highest bidder, and also Ian Kinsler was claimed off of waivers by a miss. Did we ever find out what that team was?
No, my guess is the Red Sox.
But don't worry, it's the MLB, and waivers don't matter, and roster moves just happen and don't happen.
With Pedroia getting hurt and going back to the DL with the knee injury, my guess is it's the Red Sox because they're going to need a second baseman.
Okay. Okay, so, and then I want to...
That's not confirmed, though. That's
no,
I guess.
Understand. I understand that. And I want...
You heard it here first, confirmed by Tim.
You're right.
Put it on the scroll.
Boston Red Sox.
Put it on the scroll.
It'll be on my Facebook later. I'll break that.
I also want to tell people that... I know that there's some Alavila haters out there, and I kind of want to try to make some sense. Are you an Alavila hater?
Yeah. Man, in a way, yeah. I'm not – I really don't care about the Tigers anymore. Like,
well, no, because they're not winning.
Well, it's not even that they're not winning. They're just stale. It's a boring brand of baseball. I can't watch it. It's like watching Red Wings hockey. It's like watching paint dry. It's boring as hell. It's the same shit over and over and over. They don't have any young talent. They don't have anyone that's exciting. Like, you know, if this team had a Mike Trout or a Bryce Harper or a Correa or a Mookie Betts or some young stud that you could actually be like, oh, at least the future's bright. No, we don't even have that. Like, we're shitty now, and we don't have one of those. So,
well, that's because we've been quote unquote good since 2005, so we haven't.
Well, the other thing is, yeah, we've traded away a bunch of prospects, but how many of those guys have actually been good? So that also worries me, the fact that it's not like we're trading away all these stud prospects to get these guys. So they're not stacking the minor league system neither. So,
oh man, you know who else has been good since 2005? The Boston Red Sox, and they still are.
Well, they've had a couple seasons where they were terrible.
A couple.
They had one.
And not an obvious downward trend.
They fired the manager,
trend.
And they decided to go worst to first. No big deal.
Not an obvious downward trend.
You're talking about
like
Bobby
Tigers.
Valentine?
Yeah.
Okay.
But it's not like the Tigers where they're just getting worse and worse and worse every year, well, every week, every month, every day.
Exactly. You know what the Tigers are? The Tigers are the Philadelphia Phillies. With Ryan Howard, Jimmy Rollins, Chase Utley, just all these huge contracts that they signed, and then they just waste away. They refuse to rebuild. They refuse to bring up the young guys. It's awful.
Well, I will say that I know that you don't like Alavila, but I guess if we'll get into it now because we won't get into it later.
I have another baseball question for him while we're at it, but go ahead.
I think that Alavila was stuck with some bad contracts. When all of our good players, when the Victor Martinez's and the Justin Verlanders and Miggy Cabrera's, when all these guys' contracts were up, there was almost public pressure to keep signing them. It was really people were saying, "Do not get rid of Justin Verlander."
Justin Verlander didn't need to be signed when Justin Verlander was signed. That was the problem I had with that. He still had 2 years left on his deal when they extended him. His wasn't a brand new contract. His was an extension.
To be fair, though, he's out of all those guys that got them extensions, he's playing the best.
I understand that. I get that. But Victor Martinez having a career year at like 36 or 35 or whatever he was, didn't need an extension. Didn't need a new contract. That's a guy, okay, you get the career year and you let him walk away. He's a DH only. Those guys are a dime a dozen. You mean to tell me Miggy wouldn't benefit from having some DH days?
Well, I think that they were also under pressure from the late Mike Ilitch to keep the team together to try to make a push to go for it. So that really stunted their growth because he wanted a World Series before he died and obviously didn't get one. But I think that that was part of it. I think that Alavila was just put in a bad place. And I think that he's right now he's trying to clean up a mess before it gets to be too terrible. But honestly, I've said it on this show before, we should have gotten rid of, we should have blown this team up after we got swept by Baltimore. That would have been the perfect time to just blow it up.
Yeah, that would have been the perfect time. But and you take into JD Martinez. Okay, JD should have been dealt last year. They waited until this year and got a bag of peanuts for him. They basically got nothing. That's the problem. They waited too long.
What was your baseball question?
It has to do with the Little League, whatever's going on, like Little League World Series. Did something happen with Connecticut last night or yesterday or something like that?
Yeah, what happened there? The manager got suspended?
Yeah, he got suspended for 2 games for not giving somebody an at-bat.
Oh, yeah. So, okay, in the Little League World Series, you have in Little League, period, you have to play your whole roster. Every kid gets to play.
Mm-hmm.
Participation trophy central, mm-hmm. Okay? So you have to at least sub a kid in for an at-bat. He can't not play. And sometimes you get caught because you can get mercy rule too with 10 runs after 3.5 innings if the home team is up. So there's times where if you don't get those guys in, you can get caught. And, yeah, that's the kind of things that happen.
So that's what happened?
I didn't see that game, but okay. I'm just guessing if he didn't get the hitter in,
yeah.
I'm guessing that's why.
Yeah, because and then they lost too, which was the same.
Yeah, I'll look into it.
Yeah, CEO said something about, you know, like he made it seem really bad, like this was unacceptable. And
yeah, I heard it on morning radio.
Yeah, he's like, this is unacceptable. And I thought that he had did something like, you know, how sometimes coaches will grab a player, you know, get frustrated and grab a player by the shirt or something. Like, I thought that something really egregious happened. Well, but if you tell me that's what was happening.
Well,
like,
no. Little League is big on everyone plays. And that's the biggest reason that me and my daughter are doing travel now.
We also, yeah, I was going to say, we also could get into the big free agent announcement that Lexi Kalanika is going to stay with the Diamonds. Yeah!
Yeah, thank
She's
gonna you.
She's going to keep her talents with the Diamonds.
Dude, I'll tell you what, it's been a hell of a 2 months. The fact that Marissa's still with me is fucking incredible because it's been brutal.
You said, that your girl's still with you?
Yeah, just the amount of ridiculousness that comes with this. Like, you guys would not understand. This is fucking college recruiting for 10-year-olds. People send shit to your house. People stalk you on Facebook. I got one the other day. A guy just randomly looked at my cover photo, saw she was a catcher, and said, "Oh, well, we're looking for a catcher. Has your daughter found a team yet?" I'm like, "Yeah, we've been signed for a week and a half now."
We've been signed?
Yeah, we've been, like, it's
Didn't
fucking...
you see the announcement on Twitter?
Well, it's nuts, man. Like, there was a big fight on Facebook. There's a group called Downriver Softball. And what was happening was there was people sending kids that were already signed by their team to other tryouts to find other kids. So then the parents would go there, take notes on kids that were doing good, report back to the head coach with, like,
so
oh,
scouts.
Oh, basically, yeah. Hmm. Like, it was nuts. And then there was one comment made because the bitch who left our team, the third base coach, she's a bitch.
Yeah, I was going to say bitch.
Can't fucking wait. I'm so happy she's gone. My daughter hates her with a passion. Mm-hmm. She really tried to make it seem like she was something, and my daughter just fucking despised her. That's my daughter would not have played for her ever again.
Mm-hmm.
So she went to another organization, and that organization is based out of Brighton.
Mm-hmm.
She's doing a Downriver organization, and they're going to run it out of Lincoln Park High School. Well, people are pissed. They're like, when the fuck did these Jim Harbaugh satellite camps start happening where you're bringing fucking talents down from up north to play over here downriver and take the kids, you know, away from downriver too? Like,
they're going to be hosting winter tryouts in Tampa.
Oh, it's insane. Like, I'm shocked that they're not in my backyard trying to host one in my backyard to get my daughter to sign.
Right.
It's serious.
I'm surprised you haven't gotten a car. Did you get that car from a recruit?
No.
Blink once if you did.
No.
He blinked.
No, we have been offered flowers, dinner, lunch, go to the bar.
Take that dinner. Go to Benihana. Fucking rack up that bill.
It was insane. The amount of shit that was offered to a 10-year-old to get a 10-year-old to play.
People want to win.
With that being said, she is the number one catcher in 10U next year, Class B.
It's crazy what they're doing for a 10-year-old. And he's like, but she's the best.
She is, though. No, she going
so
into
much
this
determination
going
though.
Into this year. There was coaches telling me that she could have went and tried out for a 12U team and made the 12U team.
420 blaze up.
So
420 blaze up.
No, it's
in the whitest way possible.
Yeah, you did, though. That was really bad.
Marquise, I believe it's time for Blaze.
I believe it that it's time for 420.
It's Blaze time.
It is time to Blaze.
And not in the right-wing political kind of way.
But I think that...
Not the Blaze.
No. No.
I mean, she's like so, fallen so far down. Now she's like doing her fucking hot takes from her car. Like, it's just like Tommy Lahren.
Oh.
She's like, because she got shit canned from the Blaze. And then like, and no one else wants anything to do with her because she did that. Like, she did like a media tour and she was doing okay. But then the last stop was a public debate with Chelsea Handler.
Oh, yeah, yeah. She did.
No, it was
a
public
debate
with Chelsea Handler and she revealed that she's on her parents' insurance.
Okay, so do you have a health care plan or no?
Well, luckily, I'm 24, so I am still on my parents. And to say, yeah, you can laugh. I pay my parents for it. You can laugh. I don't care. There are things. They can laugh. At least stop. She's being honest.
And everybody was like, fuck you. Like every right-wing group and every left-wing group was like, we are so done with you now. You're on your fucking own.
She's still hot.
Now she's doing fucking vlogs from her car with a selfie camera. Like
she's
just,
hot. It's okay.
They said...
still shitting likes. On Kaepernick.
Well, the first thing that happened...
Good for her.
Don't do it.
The first thing that happened...
I wanted to see the reaction.
He's baiting
you, Keith.
I was
rooting for radio there.
The first thing that happened there was that she came out pro-abortion?
She came out pro-choice.
Pro-choice. So she came out pro-choice.
Definitively
on the View,
choice. Yeah.
On the View. They didn't like that.
Yep.
And that's what cost her Blaze job.
Yep.
And then this thing with Tommy Lahren is what cost her everything. Chelsea Handler is what cost her everything else.
Because she has nothing now. She's literally just doing it from Facebook. It's like we have a bigger platform. Like,
hey, she's about a year from being on the Fappening blog.
I hope so.
A year away.
I would jerk off so many times if she actually showed up on one of those things. Like, I would probably chafe my dick
off. Who's the latest girl? Was it Bailey that had that picture?
No,
of,
she did not.
Of her
Bailey?
With the penis on her? How? With
no,
the penis on her
I
face?
Doubt that.
No, you probably, but you like that the Fappening blog, and that's like kind of fakey.
It doesn't have fakes.
It went through this.
Yeah,
you
were
defending
face.
This harder than you defend
yes.
your child.
Yes. I should have gotten this incense with my child. No, there was about a month period where I think they were experimenting with doing fakes. Other than that,
I've never been there at a time where they didn't have fakes.
No, man, there's no way.
Listen,
no way.
I will pull it up.
He will take a fucking bullet for this site.
Check it.
He
like,
would.
I do. I check it. I check
He's
it. Like
checked old, it three times this show.
I mean, last show I did. But yeah. So I do want to say on the Tigers front, not to be so hard on Alavila because he's cleaning up a mess. He's Obama in 08. And
no, but he's Obama. No, he's Obama in like 11 if Obama hadn't done anything because it's been a while. It's not like this is still his first year. He's had it for what, two seasons now?
No, this is his second. This is his first full season having the team.
When did he take over? Oh, yeah. No, I thought it was
mid-season last year. It was mid-season last year, right?
Yeah, it was mid-season.
Was it really
it was
last year?
Mid-season okay. last year.
No. Was it? No.
Yeah. I thought it was mid-season 15.
No, it was mid-season when they traded David Price. It wasn't last
2015.
Year. 2015. Yeah, he had a full year.
Yeah, he's
right?
had a full year and a half. That's what I'm saying. Like,
so then it'd
not,
be Obama 09.
Yeah,
no,
traded,
it's Obama 10 if Obama hadn't done anything. It's Obama 10 if Obama hadn't passed a single law or gotten a single like bit of legislation.
Either way it goes, he's cleaning up a mess.
He's been cleaning up a mess for fucking 22 months. Like, get over it. Like, either
it takes clean a
up,
look.
No, those, either clean up the mess or
not,
don't. No,
are,
this is the guy in the back room at a grocery store whose job it is to fucking, like, he's a fucking clerk. And they're like, go clean up all the spilled milk. And he's fucking cleaning with a fucking paper towel.
There's
like,
no,
it's a big
not,
mess. I got to clean it up.
There's not.
It's a big mess. It's going to take me a while.
Room.
He's been there for 6 hours
there's
with
no,
that fucking one napkin.
There's not much room in the MLB to, with those contracts at those places.
There were if you actually made the moves, if you had the balls to make the moves, but he doesn't. He doesn't have those balls.
I'd rather him.
Is Verlander still on this team? Why is Cabrera still on this team?
Why is Kinsler still on this team? I think they're keeping.
And I'm not even a Tigers fan.
I think they're keeping Cabrera.
But you're towing that bullshit line that's a complete fallacy.
No, they're going to completely keep. They're going to keep Cabrera.
I know they're going to keep him until he dies on this team,
mm-hmm. which is unfortunate.
I know it is.
He's got to go.
It's a waste. This team is not going anywhere for a long time.
Don't you think they're just keeping him just so that he puts their
They're fucking rolling with the Pistons. It's Joe Dumars all over again. Fucking keep the band back together. That's all it is. It's keeping the band together, man. It's fucking awful.
To be fair, that Spurs team that we lost to in 2005 stayed together until last year.
Yes, but they had different things that they brought in.
Also,
around
the
that.
Spurs team won four championships. That's entirely different.
They brought in LaMarcus Aldridge. We brought in Rodney Stuckey. There's a fucking difference.
Let's be real. The LaMarcus Aldridge and Rodney Stuckey, that's almost comparable because he's not doing too well out in San Antonio.
No, the difference is how many rings does Aldridge have now?
Yeah, none. It's zero.
Actually, zero?
None. No, it's none. But still, okay. they added other people. That's the difference. They added other
Well, their
people.
Scouting is better. Their Spurs scouting is better than the Pistons.
Well, they actually had really talented players. We didn't.
I think that we did. I think that Pistons team was excellent.
I think that Pistons team was a bunch of role players who played a perfect role for what they needed, and that was it. They weren't superstars.
For 6 years.
Yeah, but also you can't compare the Pistons to the Tigers because the Pistons won. The Tigers didn't. So nothing the Tigers did matters. That's the thing that everybody's like skimming over and all this. Like, don't want to get back to the glory days of 06. What, when you got your ass fucking handed to you in the World Series? Or 2012 when you still didn't win any games in the World Series? You're fucking terrible. Like, win a championship and then come talk to you about the glory days. Nothing has ever happened that matters in this town for baseball since 1980 fucking four. I haven't been alive. Yeah. I wasn't even alive.
I wasn't alive for Tigers World Series.
I was, let's see, that would be October 84, so I was like days old.
Yeah, and that's why people are like.
You lived through one. I didn't.
I've lived to see three of the four teams win championships.
This is why I have no emotional ties to the Pistons, the Lions, or the Tigers. Pistons a little bit because they won the championship the year I was in high school.
So you have emotional ties to the Red Wings?
Red Wings only because they were good when I was growing up. The rest of these teams have done borderline nothing. I'm going to rephrase that specifically with the Tigers and the Lions, as far as I'm concerned, nothing. They've done nothing. It doesn't matter. So you have something on paper that says you don't fucking matter.
Pistons were good during my childhood, so I was okay with that.
The Pistons kind of get a pass.
Yeah, the Pistons get a pass for me. I mean, besides the Teal days, they were good for my whole growing up, like all the way through sixth grade, all the way through high school. So I was okay with the Pistons. I was a Pistons fan. I went to games. I used to buy NBA Live and 2K and all that shit too.
Come back with Mark Miles next.
Okay, the fact that it was recorded,
that's a
in itself
huge.
Should just red flag
everything. But listen, it's what is them having it recorded is possibly what got them off.
Right. Well, figuratively. but no, seriously.
Yeah, and that's a huge...
KVRadioBroadcasting.com.
What the hell just happened there, Jason?
I was reading
what
a text
message.
That was like 2 minutes late. We hit
My mom head. Asked about a tiny dog. I was distracted. I'm sorry.
This guy is going to be the next Tech N9ne because of the way that he hustles and the way that he just puts himself out there and tries to get in touch with everybody. Mark Miles is with us right now. He is promoting his show at where's that going to be?
Yo, what's going on, Marquise, man? Thanks for having me today, bro.
You have a show coming on at the Emerald Theater, right?
Yes, show's going down Saturday, September 23rd, Emerald Theater. And I'm also going to be sharing the stage with Critical Bill, who is just about legendary around here. Shout out to my boy Power Dice. and No Resolve, man. And they're definitely one of the hottest up-and-coming rock bands on the scene right now. That's going to be a huge show, man. Everybody's invited, all ages.
Critical Build's been on the scene for a while, man.
Yeah. I think 15 years or so, man.
Yeah, I remember, I think they did some stuff with ICP back in the day, I want to say.
Tech Nine and I think Strange. They were on tour and everything, man.
So what's been going on with you, man? Because I listened to your new song that we're going to play next. The one thing that I could say about the new song, which we will play next, and for the podcast listeners, we'll play it for them too.
We have permission this time.
Yeah, we have permission. It's unlike Kanye. Do we have your permission to play the song? You're not going to do like Kanye.
Man.
You're not going to do us like Kanye West did us, right?
Nothing but love, bro.
But no, the one thing I noticed about this is that your music seems to be maturing. Am I right or am I wrong about that?
Well, definitely, as time progresses, keep getting better and better. But not just for myself, it's just the people I'm able to work with as well, the relationships I've been able to establish, and my production values have gotten better based on the producers and things I'm working with. And things have definitely, you know, went to a new level over the last year or so. So definitely, I appreciate you noticing the music growing like that.
I've actually noticed that you've been maturing too, because tell me if I'm wrong, but when I first met you, you were this baby face guy just coming in, wanting to freestyle, happy to be on any show that I have you. Now you got the beard going, you know, you out there in a nice ride. I see you going out to Jamaica every 2 months, man. What's going on, man? What's good with you?
Definitely. I've grown up a little bit myself, man. Definitely from the time we met. Young, wild, crazy motherfucker, just ready to do everything. I've really kind of settled down. I think it's the music industry just kind of seasons you up a little bit, and it kind of changes your attitude once you've been in it long enough, you know.
Let's be real, it's the girlfriend. Shout out to Megan. It's the girlfriend.
Yes, she's more than the girlfriend, the queen.
Yeah, is she around you? Because I saw her put on Facebook the other day. She's tired of people asking her when she's going to get proposed to, and I just want to ask her when is she going to get proposed to.
I know, please, bro. No, she's not around at the moment. But yeah, shout out to my girl, man. She held me down, and I knew what was good for me. I'd lock that in.
And shout out to her, man. She was always nice to me, even though the first time I met her, she stared at me for 2 hours like I just spit oil in her face.
Remember, she didn't know that Fresh Prince and Jazzy Jeff song?
She did not know that the Fresh Prince, Jazzy Jeff summertime song. Have you played that for her yet?
Oh, yeah.
Because I feel like that's that and Today is a Good Day is considered probably the best hip-hop songs of all time, just because of the fact those are two songs that no matter what genre of music you like those songs. So you could hate rap, but you don't like Summertime?
No.
No?
No.
What? Tim doesn't like Summertime? Oh, come on. It's the most harmless hip-hop song in history. Okay.
Yeah.
So what about some of the other shows you've done, man? Because I want to ask you about some of the shows you've done, but I have another question with you. But tell me about the shows. How have your shows changed in the last 3 years?
Oh, my God. Dude, so when I first came out, it was just little old me just trying to do my thing, you know, and I'd get on the stage and I'd rock it as hard as I could. But, you know, since then, this thing's became a whole production now. When I do my shows, I'm on the scene with two DJs called Boys Too Hype. They are probably one of the hypest up-and-coming, highly anticipated DJ duos on the scene. Young cats, and they're definitely on their grind. But I also got stage dancers now, and I got production crew, light technicians, sound people, vocal mixers. I mean, it's a lot of people that come together to make my shows happen nowadays.
That's good, man. I wanted to ask you about your team because you got your man, I want to say Chad.
Chad X.
Yeah. I want to say Chad, man. He really got you out there because not only he's management, he's photography, he's videography. I don't know if he's editing, but it also seems like he's music. That man is a renaissance of everything.
Yes, man. When I met Chaddix, I actually brought him through their cave radio when
you did.
We first started working.
You did.
That was right at the beginning of us working. And, you know, I hustled really hard on my own as an independent artist before I met him. and he recognized my work ethic, and he took me on as a client. And it's definitely a selling point that not only is he a great manager, but he has the ability to do the marketing, the photography, the videography, everything like you're saying. It's, we make a killer team.
You didn't ask. I asked you this the first time, and you weren't experienced enough to actually have an answer for me. So I'll ask you this 3 years later. Who's the guy so far that's come up to you that that really awed you in the way that they liked your music?
You mean like it wowed me, or I was like somebody who I'd be starstruck by or something like that?
Anybody that's come up, someone you'd either be starstruck by or someone that really touched you in the way that they said that they appreciate your music.
Well, actually, just recently, funny enough that you'd say, it actually was a very big surprise to me. I don't know if you're familiar with a guy named Doug Podell.
Yep.
And I was actually on his show this morning doing an interview, and I met him for the first time personally today. But he had reached out to me a little while back when he heard Angel Wings, and he was very touched by the song. He really liked it. His wife really liked it. And he's a rock and roll guy. You know, he's not reaching out to too many hip-hop type guys. And he extended a hand to me to try to help me out as an artist. He got me onto his show for an interview. He plays my music videos. And in the music industry, there's a lot of people that either they want money from you, or they want this from you, or they want that from you, or you gotta kiss a lot of ass to get any love from anybody sometimes, when there's other guys like him that come out of the woodwork purely because they organically just like your music and they want to help you. And that is something I can really appreciate.
So when do I get my check for this interview?
Right.
No, I'll come
talk to the upper management, see if we can't get you one cut.
One of my favorite shows that we've ever done from the local Spin Days was the day that it was you, the City Lights crew, and Xander Michigan in here doing folk rap.
Yeah, I remember that day.
I think Jay Saylor was here. Shout out to Jay Saylor.
Jay Kidd.
Jay Kidd. And also shout out to City Lights, man. You'll be home soon, my guy.
Yeah, it's been a minute, man. It's been a minute for sure.
He's away right now, but he'll be back. He'll be back. I think next year he'll be back.
Yeah, man.
So
that's a tough thing.
So what's going on at the Emerald Theater? When's that show?
That's right around the corner, Saturday, September 23rd, and I'm going to be the hip-hop guy on the show. Otherwise, it's a rock and roll show. So it's kind of cool. We got the best of both worlds, and it's going to be a sold-out show, man. It's going to have hundreds of people there. It's going to be huge. And it's definitely the biggest show to hit this place since it reopened, and I think it's been closed for over 10 years.
When are we going to get the full-blown tour?
Man, I'm definitely working towards that. I think with everything that we do, it kind of opens the next door, and everything that we do is strategically done. And by we, of course, I'm a solo artist, but I mean my team, my management, everybody behind me. Everything we do just keeps opening doors, and we're going to come into the right opportunity, and it's going to take off.
You're getting to the point where this becomes everything, right? You're getting to that point where you don't need a job. Like this becomes it.
Yeah, I'm actually getting closer, man, and that's actually because I do got a regular job, you know, and it's just gonna have to come a time where you're gonna make it or break it. So you've got to wait for that time, I guess.
Get a little personal with you, man. Best spot that you've vacationed so far, because I've seen you go everywhere, and honestly, I'm jealous. Like honestly, I see your vacation pictures, and I'm like, man, fuck that guy. He don't deserve it.
Hey, I'd say the best place, if you can go anywhere, Cayman Islands, bro. That shit is paradise, bro. Clearest, bluest waters, most beautiful white sands. Very, very upper class, very nice. Cayman Islands, definitely. But if you're going to stay in the United States, man, go down to, like, Clearwater, Florida. It's a great place.
I'm moving to Hawaii, man. As soon as my kid turns 18 and I know, like, what he's doing with his life, I'm moving to Hawaii, man. Forget this place.
Yeah, I've never been, but That's definitely a place on my bucket list.
Let me get my roots out there so I can bring you out. I can bring you and the future wife out.
Yeah, for sure, man. But
All right, so
I appreciate the opportunity to call in and talk a little bit about what I got going on.
Yeah, I was gonna ask you that. Time, so. Tell me about On My Way to the Top, man. Tell me about like how the song came up. You know, who produced it? Tell me about all that.
This track right here is the very first single I've released since my Mr. 24/7 EP last year, and this one kind of came out of nowhere. Actually, a producer duo called Wax Monkeys, who I was completely unfamiliar with, hit me up and sent me this beat. And at the time, I was really frustrated with just some of the things I was going through as a independent artist and some of the struggles and some of the things I had to overcome. So you can kind of hear in the song, like, my attitude, like, I'm kind of fucking mad and, like, aggravated by shit. Like, I'm on the rise. They want to see me fall. You know, it's like I was just in that state of mind, and the song just kind of wrote itself. So from there, we just rocked it out. But that's kind of what inspired it, was everything that I go through, the trials and tribulations and the struggles and the overcomings of being in the game and doing this.
Well, man, I got to tell you, man, before I get you out of here, I have one more question for you before I get you out of here. But I do want to tell you, I am proud of all the progress you've made, man. It's almost like there are very few artists that started, that were just starting when we were starting as a show, and to watch all of our parallel growth, to watch how you've grown and to watch how our show has grown, man. It's like, I really feel like we all have like a special connection here, man. My last question is, what's the thing that annoys you the most about the music industry?
You know what? Well, the fucking thing that annoys me the most is it's about 20% music and 80% everything else. So if you get into this because you like music or you love music and music's what inspires you and music's what you want to do, it's kind of like joining the baseball team and you just wanted to play baseball, but they got you grooming the field and cutting the grass and wiping down the seats and advertising for the fucking stadium and everything else. So that's kind of the whole thing, is it's just not the music. It's a whole lot of things that go with it that not everybody really sees.
All right, Mark, thank you for calling in. No, I was not trying to call you Mike. I was looking at my co-host that just walked in full of wet and fatness because he just closed the windows to my car. Do you want to introduce this song real quick?
Yeah, man, I want to tell everybody, go out, download the new song, stream it. It's available anywhere you get your music, iTunes, Apple, Spotify, Tidal. Even YouTube, it's everywhere. So go out there, get it. I appreciate everyone's support. This one's called On My Way to the Top.
And
I'll be rocking it Saturday, September 23rd, and I want to see everybody there.
All right, man, we got to get you back in here to come hang out. Real quick before I get you out here, Lions record this year, what's it going to be?
Oh, man. I'm just going to go on a limb and say undefeated, man, because I got the pride in our team like that, whether I'm let down or not.
And that's why you're in music. All right, we come back and talk more with Tim and Jason next. Here's On My Way to the Top.
They gon' try to take my cash. They gon' try to put me on blast.
On my way to the top.
They gon' try to knock my style. They gon' try to take my cash. They gon' try to put me on blast.
On my way to the top.
They gon' try to stop my shine. They gon' try to take what's mine. They gon' try.
They wanna see me fall. The same ones salute me when they see me at the mall. Two-faced, these snakes, not associates. I ain't even sweating, check you when the time's appropriate. Now I'm chilling, plotting on my next move. Which club I wanna hop out for, straight flex loose. Die for my crown, live by the code, by the code. Tell them get up out my lane, cause I'm back on the road.
They gon' try to knock my style. They gon' try. Take my cash. They gon' try to put me on blast.
On my way to the top.
They gon' try to stop my shine. They gon' try to take what's mine.
they gon' try to test my patience. On my way. And as a youngin', they couldn't tell me nothing. A little crazy motherfucker always getting into something. Kicked it with my cousin, we was getting into trouble. Even back then, we were all about the hustle. Fresh J's, still match my fitted. From the burbs, I still ran my city. Nowadays, I've been on the same shit. Born to make it. I'm a legend in the making. They gon' try to knock my style. They gon' try to take my cash. They gon' try to put me on blast.
On my way to the top.
They gon' try to stop my shine. They gon' try to take what's mine. They gon' try to test my patience.
On my way to the top.
Spent 25 years trying to find myself. I built this whole empire by myself. Made my way through the game, trying to make a name, trying to do my thing. Fuck the fortune and the fame. Ways to defeat me, haters wanna plot those. Girls, cars in the crib, yeah, I got those. Just trying to see my team on the top floor. More money, more problems, yeah, I got both. They gon' try to knock my style. They gon' try to take my cash. They gon' try to put me on blast.
On my way to the top.
They gon' try to stop my shine. They gon' try to take what's mine. They gon' try to test my patience.
On my way to the top.
The Cavs are imploding, man. That team is breaking up.
You are listening to Fanarchy on CRBRadio.com.
Okay, that was the perfect time for you to stuff your face full of chips.
As our senior basketball expert.
One place I could go and actually talk to someone has
both chips. Me and Angie look to it. He's just...
Thanks to Mark Miles for joining us. Make sure you go and cop the new single, On My Way to the Top. That is a really good song. I'm glad that you guys on the podcast got to hear it, too, because it's probably the first time I've ever played a song over the podcast. Because, you know, I like Mark Miles. He's good too.
This is the first time I've ever done this show wet.
Just going to leave that one there.
Okay.
Soaking wet.
But you're not the first person that's ever done the show.
No, first just time first time I've for ever you. Done, yeah.
I guess Wilson's not showing up. Okay.
He's busy getting wet.
Hopefully getting someone else wet.
Can we talk about Sarahah?
Yes.
It's fucking insane.
Yes, I was going to do it when we were I was going to segue that from talking about Usher giving girls herpes, but, you know.
Oh, well, go ahead.
That was the next segment.
I didn't mean to jump ahead. I'm sorry.
That was the next segment, but no, go ahead.
No, I don't want to jump ahead. No.
No, go
ahead. You got a plan.
You already mentioned it.
Okay.
He does it.
But you got a plan.
He does this all the time where he'll mention something. And I'll be like, no, we were going to do this later. And then he'll be like, and then he'll already let the cat out the bag. And I can't right. Just be like.
Well, he couldn't wait to tell me what it was
earlier. Inside baseball, 80% of the time later means I'm not getting to it. I'm just covering my ass because I really want to talk about it.
Okay, go ahead.
Because it's been a fucking nutballs week and I'm sure you've seen it too. Somehow, Tim, it escaped you. I don't know how.
Yeah, it escaped me until you talked about it. And then really? I had to look it up. Yeah, I had to look it up. And.
Did it not cross the race line? Like, is it one of those things like where you know about something and I don't, or I know about something and you
no,
don't?
No.
Well, you're the one who came up with that the phrase a couple months ago. You said, sometimes things don't cross the race line, Jason. Like, you were lecturing me, so I'm just making sure. So, the app for, you know, we touched on it earlier, but for the listeners who don't know, Sarahah, it's spelled like Sarah with an extra A-H at the end, is an app that allows, you know, a user one creates a user that... is a known quantity, so it's your name, or, you know, people know it's you because you posted on your Facebook, and then everyone in the world is allowed to just go leave anonymous comments on your page. So it's basically like what was that called? Like Live Journal Secrets back in the day, or Post Secrets, or Tumblr Secrets. Like, this has been a thing on the internet for a long, long time. It's like different versions of anonymity, but it's never been directed before. Like, this is the first time I've seen this. And the reason I wanted to talk about it is to, well, I wish anybody else had any experience with it, is to talk about the difference in what the pages are. So, say, so Tim, if you started one, it would be people who either don't like you posting or inside jokes. So it would be like, fuck you, Tim, you suck, your daughter sucks, whatever. Or it would be like, you like that rusty nail in your coffee mug, and you'd be like, hey, that's John. Like, you would know instantly, you know what I mean? Girls' pages, it doesn't matter if you're hot, ugly, thick, thin, fucking, you know, have some kind of like learning disability, missing arms. It doesn't matter what you are. You are only getting, for some reason, you're only getting female posts, which are like, you're the light in my life and you're the best. Or you're getting, I want to fucking pee on you and suck you, fuck shit, piss, fuck you. Like, the most raunchy shit that you can ever see. Like, it doesn't matter if you're like a mom, like just posting like, this is fun, let's see what my friends have to say. And it's like, I want to lick your taint. Like, it's like it is so strange that like the difference in sexes, like the difference in reactions. Because every guy that I've seen, it's just inside jokes and like, you know, I would drag my dick through broken glass just to hear you fart into a walkie-talkie. Like, that's a phrase that's going around on Sarahah. But the girls one is all like, I've loved you since the day I met you, and not getting with you was the worst decision I ever made. Or, I want to fucking come on your face. Like, I don't know why.
Well, because, I mean, that's, well, that, it's basically, you just basically been social media.
Yeah, I was going to say, that's, you just explained media. Instagram.
Yeah.
I don't know if you knew that or
except,
not.
Except, you know, your name is tagged along
too. That's the difference, though. Yeah, that's the biggest difference. People are getting fucking raunchy.
So you're more, you know, you're more likely to tell, you know, someone that you're close to in anonymity that you would lick their taint.
Tongue punch their fart box.
Drink their bath water.
Well, you would say that on air. You don't care. You've said that on air.
Who did I say that about?
I don't remember, but you said it last year.
You know, I probably did.
Probably to Sky.
probably that. How about that girl?
I want to drink that girl's bathwater. She's 9. Shit!
her bathwater is full of Johnson & Johnson.
No more tears. On my tongue. But yeah, no, I've never seen it to take it to such an extreme level where it's like, people are just, like, making it, and they're just like, people are quitting in days now. Like, they're like, I made one, and then 2 days later, fuck that thing. I never want to do that again.
And now
I don't need to know that everyone I know wants to fuck me.
And now you're looking at your circle of friends like, which one of you said it?
Which one of you motherfuckers said it?
Now, on the other side of things, like, my version is I have 4 posts in 6 days. Like, nobody's just like,
yeah, I don't have
friends. Fuck that guy. Yeah.
Like, I don't have friends, so no one would comment on
he doesn't have friends. He just has people that want to recruit his daughter.
Yeah. Like, yeah, you're Steve Rodriguez in 1994.
he's literally the guy that you get to get to his daughter.
That is true.
Like it is. Like they know that they have to make him happy. You know, we've all joked about Tim and his obsession with softball and baseball, and then it hit me one day looking at the college women's World Series. I'm like, wait a minute, this is what this is all about. He ain't trying to pay for college.
Oh, that's all I'm trying to – I shouldn't say that's all I'm trying to do. I enjoy every fucking second of it because I get to spend time with my daughter.
Will you stop calling me sir on social media, please?
No, man. I always – everyone's sir and everyone's ma'am. I was raised right.
I'm your friend.
As
I
burp into a microphone over here.
Right, right. Total different thing right there. But no. Yeah, it's all about getting her to college, man. That's the goal. Just
– where would you want her to go?
Her goal is
U of M?
Our goal is U of M.
Our goal.
Well, no. Her goal personally is U of M, but mine and Marissa's goal is also U of M because
keep her in the state.
It doesn't matter where she goes, as long as they're paying for college. Marissa's moving there. Like it, there's no. We will up
Villanova,
and leave.
Here we come.
Yeah, we will up and leave and go wherever the hell she goes because Marissa will not be apart from her for that long. Like she couldn't go to Florida. And be like, all right, going to Florida. See you guys, Thanksgiving I get a break?
Yeah, no, that's not going
to
work.
That would be unacceptable. No, Marissa would never allow that.
No,
I'm not going to say I would allow that, but Marissa would never fucking
let
that
fly. You know what goes down in college.
Well, I also, yes, I'm also not stupid. So
I didn't have to go to college to find out what goes down in college.
Doesn't need to take a college education.
No, it doesn't even take a college education. It just takes a couple of nights spent in a dorm room. Well, that's it.
One of the things that happens in college is that student athletes are forced to be athletes and students. Another great segue.
And a lot of Mario Kart.
And a lot of Mario Kart.
That was at MSU, dude.
Mario Kart and chill.
Oh, my God. It was fucking nuts.
That sounds like what I would say to get the girl to come over. Like, hey, you want to come over and play
no,
some Mario
Kart? No, they're literally on my brother's dorm room floor. There'd be like fucking 12 doors open, and you'd hear the Mario Kart theme in all 12 doors. And you just roll into people's rooms, and you play Mario Kart and drink. And it was like the fucking nerdiest shit ever. I'm like, this is not what I pictured.
One of the things that I wanted to talk about with Josh Rosen, he is a quarterback for UCLA. I will preface this by saying he's a smart kid, but he went on record as saying that college and student athletes shouldn't be inclusive. It should be exclusive. Either you're a college athlete or you are a student. They were saying that, you know, being a student and being an athlete is like having two full-time jobs, neither of which you get paid for. He did the Cardale Jones thing where it's like, I came here to play football. I didn't come here to play school. I was just wondering what your thoughts on that are. I should probably get the actual quote from him.
My thoughts are you just described every person who gets a job that could be a career in year three. Like, it's like people don't know now that you have to eat shit for a while before everything is awesome. Mm-hmm. So, yeah, it sucks being in college and playing football, and that's a lot of pressure and stuff, but later on it's not as bad. Like, really all I would say to those people is quit your bitching and time moves quicker the older you get. Like, I know that sounds very stupid.
Look at this guy preaching wisdom over here.
Well, I know that sounds very stupid, but, like, if you approach me in month six of my tenure at, like, my current job, I'd be like, this fucking sucks. I can't take a day off. I got to work fucking 10-hour days every day. This is bullshit. If I'm late one day, I got to fucking write up. This is fucking garbage. But then 4 years later, it's like, oh, I can take time off whenever I want. Like, I'm not really going to get written up. Like, you have to put in time doing garbage bullshit.
You got
to
build equity.
Yeah, you got to.
Yourself.
Yeah, but not even just in yourself, but even look at it, if you look at each college as its own institution, like, you don't matter until you matter. Like, just look at it from that perspective. Walking onto that campus, until you're good, you're just a prospect. You're fucking nobody. So, I'm sorry you have to do... Or you have to look at it like you're trying to get to the NFL.
But you know what, though? That goes back to parenting. That goes right back to parenting because these kids are built up that way. They're built up to think that they're somebody, even though they're nobody. The second you step on a college campus, you're nobody. You're back to square one.
Yeah.
You got to prove you belong... And no one gives a damn about you. That's no matter how it is. No matter what sport you play, until you prove something,
what
it doesn't
matter.
What sport
you play, what industry you're in,
it doesn't matter. Well, you have to
That's like me getting on here and be like, why isn't Fanarchy getting 10,000 downloads every fucking week? Because nobody knows us. We have to put in time doing shit for a while.
We've done 4 years. I think that we are worth at least.
I instantly, as soon as I started that metaphor, I'm like, Keith is going to say.
He's going to, yeah, you, that was a bad
like,
one.
Like, you've
bad,
been doing yeah. this for a year. I've been doing this for four. No, I mean this show.
Oh, okay.
This show. By the way, let's see. August 26th will be the 4 year anniversary of our show.
Cool.
No, the 19th. The 19th.
Oh, so next show.
Yeah. Wow. Okay. Yeah. That's I think we've hit. I think we've hit 200 shows. I think.
Probably.
Yeah. Probably.
You don't number the episodes or anything, so.
No.
Well, if it's going to be 2 years and you've done it every week for 2 years.
Wilson just woke
52
up.
52 weeks and 52 weeks and 52 weeks.
Yeah, but
we
also skipped
weeks.
A bunch,
we skipped
too.
A couple weeks. I think we've maybe skipped like five shows the whole year.
It's probably closer to like 15.
Okay, total. So you're probably about,
no.
you're probably about 199
no,
episodes.
We have not missed 15 to 20 shows in 4 years.
Easily. Yeah.
No. No.
Yeah. It's been like no. eight since I've started. So
no,
yeah.
we've done no, we no, we missed 3 weeks last year.
You want to see Keys get mad and four. Flip yes. the table? Like, that's what you're trying to do, aren't you?
No, four.
We missed four last year, and we missed
was four last year.
Two this year.
Three this year.
What three did we miss? Well, I mean, we took 2 weeks off,
and then the week before that.
Yeah, then you're at like the 180s. Then you're not yeah. fucking get your shows up, bro.
Get fuck out of here.
Get your shows up before you come at come with a conversation like that. Okay. We're almost at 200.
Okay. Yours didn't even make 50, all
right?
We're
hey, 200 episodes. Hey, is that my fault that that happened? Because I know I put in about 50 shows during that time just appearing on everyone else's shows.
Hey, guys, oh, okay. My show only made it 3 episodes, so suck it, all of you.
So Josh Rosen's quote was, look, football and school don't go together. They just don't. Trying to do both is like trying to do 2 full-time jobs.
Wah.
These are guys who have no business being in school because they are here because this is their path to the NFL.
You know what, then? Fine. From now on, everybody who could potentially be in football, you're just playing football from the minute you're fucking 11. You don't need an education, so fuck it.
Well, in Japan, that's okay.
Yeah, right.
That's what they do with their baseball. Yeah,
baseball's gonna say. You're
I mean,
baseball.
In your sport, hockey, they do that.
No, they don't. No, the fuck, they don't.
Some of them skip college, don't they?
No, they don't.
Yes, they do.
Skip college, not. Yeah.
Well, that's what he just said. He said some of them skip college, and you said, but no, they don't.
No, I'm sorry, he didn't. I meant no, they don't skip education.
Oh,
like,
okay.
My being 11, but we're not talking about like skipping college.
No one's in. Well, this is what this is all about. Is they're saying like
he's saying they should be in college to play football. He's not saying they should skip college.
He's saying that they don't mix. But more of
then they should okay. Then they should just cancel the NCAA football.
There's no
that's the other way.
Too much money. I'd be fine. They'd lose way too much money.
I'd be 100%.
No, you would not be fine with that.
Yeah, I would.
No, because
I'm actually look. I'm borderline. I told him last week. I am borderline like boycotting the NFL. Borderline.
Okay, so you get rid of college athletics.
His new name is Kiesernick.
If you get rid of college athletics, you lose a ton of money to colleges. You don't understand how much athletic programs fund a lot of the stuff that goes on.
I do,
schools.
And that's why I said it. Because
except for the players.
Because I know that would never happen. Like, I know that there's no chance you're ever going to get rid of college or athletics in college.
Like,
so all this quote is somebody just going,
no U of M football means there's no U of M softball, period. Like, no.
Well, I mean, here's my thing. Well, let me finish this quote because I got something for that.
Okay.
There are guys who have no business being in school, but they're here because it's their path to the NFL. There is no other way. There's the other side that says raise the SAT eligibility requirements. Okay. Raise the SAT requirements at Alabama and see what kind of team they have. You lose athletes, and then the product on the field suffers. Any time any player puts into school will take away from time they could be putting into football. They don't realize that because they're getting screwed until it's too late. You have a bunch of people at the universities who are supposed to help you out, and they're more interested in helping you stay eligible. At some point, universities have to do more to prepare players for university life and help them succeed beyond football. There's so much money being made in this sport. It's a crime to not have everything you can do help people who are making it for those who are spending it. You thoroughly disagree with that?
Yeah.
Okay.
Grow the fuck up. Like that's what college is about. Whether you play football, whether you go there and are just a student. College is about growing the fuck up. And it sounds right there. He wants shit handed to him. And that's the way it sounds. He wants it handed to him. Well, I don't want to do schoolwork. I want to just go and play football.
Mind you, this is a kid with a high GPA. Like, this kid is actually doing it successfully.
Then what's it matter? Why does he care?
He could be talking up for other people.
Especially since we're already talking about the most fucking pampered section of college anyways.
Right.
These guys are fucking borderline limo-driven from class to class. Like, that's how easy their lives are. Have you seen the fucking locker rooms in Texas? Like, they got
we talked about that.
Flat panel TVs with their fucking logo and jersey name and shit like that on there.
Each locker costs about $10,000.
The next time a college football player complains to me, somebody who had to go to fucking Wayne State by himself and pay for it, and I'm still paying for it despite the fact that I don't have a degree because I didn't have somebody fucking holding my hand through all of it.
You also weren't talented enough to get a scholarship in anything.
Yeah, so suck my balls. I don't care if you're talented or not. You already are pampered enough. You don't need anything else. Like, how much more do you need?
Actual money for the labor.
Oh, I agree there, but I agree to a certain extent.
I disagree.
I agree that you do need money, but I don't think you need to be pampered anymore.
I
unless
disagree.
You can afford
if
to pamper.
If you want money, then basically you have to pay for your own school.
I'm sure a lot of them, if they can get a cut, they would rather pay for their school. But here's the thing: they came to them. You know,
I get that.
Most of the time, the colleges come to you.
I get that. But if you're going to pay them, then
It doesn't even equate to what they would get. Like they get their room and board paid for, but that doesn't help them with laundry. That doesn't help them with, you know, maybe taking a girl out on a date, doing some things that regular.
Oh man, you mean they can't fuck everyone? Oh, that's got to be so tough for them.
Listen, man, Antonio Cromartie did it.
Being the star quarterback of a major college in the NCAA, and they can't get laid. I don't give a fuck.
I said take a girl out on a date.
I don't give a fuck because you have a scholarship.
Just because you
then go get a fucking job on the weekend.
They can't get a job.
No, get a job on Thursday.
They can't.
There is one day a week that you're not in football.
No, they can't get a job, but they do get a stipend.
Yeah, they get a small stipend.
Okay.
Figure it out. Yeah. Figure it out. It's
The thing is, those kids don't have to worry about food. They have food 24/7 in their athletic buildings for teams. So they don't have to worry about food. Their board is paid for. Their college is paid for.
That still doesn't mean that they make
a lot
of money.
But, Tim, they don't have Netflix for free.
They need to look.
And they don't get free condoms.
I'm all about giving.
They do get free condoms.
Wait, what? I was joking.
You think they don't tell these kids to
strap it up?
Strap it up. Prepare for NFL life. You got to. I mean, are you kidding me?
I'm all about just because you're given certain privileges doesn't mean you still aren't owed what you're owed.
Well, why are they owed that?
Owed.
Okay, so. What is it roughly for tuition to, let's say, like Michigan?
$100,000 a year.
Okay, $100,000 a year.
Uh-huh. Tuition at Michigan?
Yeah.
No.
No, that's not right. It's like 40.
Then look it up.
It's not $100,000.
No, it's not.
Well,
it's
then look it up. Research guy, get on that.
What? I'm not the research guy.
You are today.
Fuck both of you.
Well, you brought it. You brought it up.
Okay.
So you brought it up. So give us the answer.
Okay. So let's just go with $50,000. Okay. It's $50,000 to attend University of Michigan. You're getting that $50,000.
Your room in-state and board $29,000, out of state $60,000.
Is that a semester or is that like a year?
It says cost of attendance.
Okay, so $30,000. So you hand that kid $30,000 and say that's here's your $30,000. You want to play football here? You have to pay for schooling.
And then he could just say, "I'll go to Alabama." Well, they'll pay for both. They'll just give me both.
But again, then if NCAA finds out about that, you can't pay for the child's schooling if you're already paying the child.
I think that is wrong. That all these kids, that you could give them something.
They get something.
They don't. They don't get enough. They don't get enough. College kids, college athletes don't get enough when they can't eat. When they can't make. They had a kid who just quit college because the NCAA made him pick between getting money off of his YouTube channel and being a kicker.
Well, yeah, because you can't go get outside money.
Why not?
It's the rules.
You're an American adult. If someone wants to pay you to do something, they should be able to pay you to do. Look, it's the example I use all the time. If a kid goes to Michigan on a music scholarship and then he gets paid to go play at a bar mitzvah, no one says anything. Nobody. And they can do that, and nobody will care. So why is it where I don't want to say the minority kids, even though they are kind of the minority kids in the sense where they are the poor kids most of the time, they're going to pick poor kids out of their community. They're already getting educations that they're not eligible for. They're not eligible for the educations that they're receiving for free because the school system that they came from isn't good enough to teach any of the kids that are in any of these school systems, and then they get there and they have to take some bullshit. Like, I think they were saying Ron Dane took turf management as a major because they just want to get the kids through school. They don't care about their educations. They just care about winning games. So why is it fair that Nick Saban gets his house paid for, gets a jet paid for, gets all this other kind of stuff paid for, and all he does is just go out there and coaches? Jim Harbaugh has how many million-dollar coaches on his on his payroll?
Okay, so looking at the average for an athlete, somewhere between $5,000 to $8,000 they get on top of that college being paid for, on top of food being paid for, on top of clothing being paid for.
So let's say, well, Their clothing.
The clothing that they're paid for.
It's paid for them. Is the
no? They're not handing right
the jumpsuits and all other.
But
shit.
It's the stuff you see every athlete walking around in on campus.
You don't want to see your kids out there in anything. Like, you never see these athletes in anything other than their school colors, because you don't want them wearing anything else.
Right.
They basically can't wear anything
else.
It's
free Jordan stuff, free Nike stuff, free Under Armour stuff. I mean, it's still, dude. It's just a perk.
Just because you get a lot of perks, don't mean that you still don't have to get paid what you owed.
What are they owed?
I'm low key planning a party over here, by the way.
What are they owed though? That's what I'd like to know. What are they owed?
In your mind, what's the number?
What would be the number?
Yeah.
Because it's not the NFL. We got to make that perfectly clear. NFL is a job. This is not a job.
But they make them treat it like a job in every way except for paying them. It's a job to them in every single way.
They do pay them. They pay for their schooling.
Hey, you know, the first 2 years I worked for my company, I didn't make shit.
And guess what? Here's the kicker to all this, and this is the part you're forgetting. Most of these kids aren't going to play in the NFL. So most of these kids could use that college education more than they could anything else. But because some of them are actually going to have to rely on that
also,
to go get jobs outside of football.
Also, most of those kids wouldn't be eligible academically for that education had they not been good at whatever sport that they're in.
Right.
And the thing is,
so they brought them
in.
This is only
an issue. What I'm saying is, they're going to get into the classroom and not know what the fuck to do.
It's only an issue. It's only an issue for the Cam Newtons. It's only an issue for this guy. It's only an issue for, you know, the fucking top tier people. They're the ones that are the ones that are really bitching about it.
It's only an issue in baseball or in basketball and football. Like, that's the only place where it's an issue, because in places like softball or in swimming and all this other stuff, they normally come from families where they could say, here's the credit card if you need something.
Fuck out of here. Are you serious?
What?
So you're making it a race thing is what you're doing then?
No.
He makes everything a race
No,
thing.
What I'm Jeez. Saying is that those are...
Well, you didn't know that?
What I'm
is
saying
that
is that those are normally sports that are very
no,
expensive
it's not.
And come from...
It's not.
More affluent families. I mean, maybe Lex is going to have some issues with not being able to get the credit card because, you know, dad can't.
I don't even have a credit card.
That's what I'm saying.
If I ain't got it, you ain't getting it.
That's what I'm saying.
Like, that's how I roll. No, man. No, bullshit. Because you could take football, you could take basketball, baseball, hockey. It's all the same, man. It's all the same. It doesn't matter. At the end of the day, most of those kids aren't going to the next level. So if most of them aren't going to the next level, they're not going to get paid to play that sport at the next level. Therefore, that college education is going to help them the rest of their life.
These kids are treated like pros in every way except for being paid.
Okay, so
they're treated like pros.
So it goes back to the age-old saying, you give a man a fish, you feed him for a day. You teach a man to fish, you feed him for a lifetime. Same thing. You give those kids the money right now.
But meanwhile, they're doing all the fishing, and everyone that's sitting on shore gets all the fish.
No, you're misappropriating the metaphor.
You're not. No, they get the fish now. Okay, so you give them their money in college.
That's the metaphor.
And when after their 3 to 4 years are done, and they're not NFL players, because let's be clear, most of them won't be,
because they're 83% of the NCAA.
Right.
Or 93. Sorry.
Right, so
I just don't get why you guys
let him finish his thought.
So, okay, your 4 years is done. Okay, it's fuck you. See you. Have a nice day. Enjoy life. We didn't do nothing for you, but let you play for 4 fucking years here.
You now have a degree in life vestology.
Right. No, you don't get a degree. According to this kid, you don't get a degree because you can't school and football. Remember,
oh, yeah,
so he's not going
right.
to school. So you came here for 4 years.
He has good grades. He actually has good grades.
That's not the metaphor.
Okay, fucking Joe Blow, offensive tackle. Okay, he's backup offensive tackle. His name is Joe fucking Blow. Okay, mm-hmm. Joe Blow's done with his 4 years of school. Joe Blow says, "Thank you for my time here. I know I'm not good enough to go to the NFL." Okay, now I'm going to go work at Burger King because I have nothing. Because all this was for me was football for 4 years. Now, Joe Blow, offensive tackle, who might have a shitty fucking degree, but at least he went to school and has some type of degree to go get some type of job. Whether it's fucking public communications or whatever, it's still a degree that he can walk in somewhere and say, I have a degree.
I'm not going to the NFL. I have a degree. Hire me. It's still better than nothing.
Still should get paid.
Oh, my God.
I mean, these are adults. These are 18-year-old adults.
Okay, so then if they get paid, they don't get school, right?
I think you should make a commission on jersey sales, and that's it. That's what I would say. If they sell a jersey with your number on it, whether it has your name or not, you should get 5% of that sale.
When you see how many billions that millions, but the NCAA makes billions off of TV rights and all this other stuff, I think that they could fund when you were talking about the lower class sports. All those sports are on ESPN.
A lot of those sports are funded. The rowing team is funded by U of M football. Okay, funded because of the fucking rowing team.
Okay, well, just like in the rest of the world, just like in the real world, either you make the money for yourself or you don't get it. So the rowing team should be out there trying to make money for their team.
That's cute. I mean, that doesn't mean anything, though.
Yeah, it does.
I mean, that's easy to say, but now imagine a world where the rowing team is trying to make money and people are like, rowing? No, fuck you.
Yeah, fuck you.
So you want to abolish a sport because they can't make money?
Yeah, because that's how it is in business when you get into the real world. If you can't generate money for your business, then your business shuts down.
So if that's the case,
I mean, why
do libraries exist? They don't generate money. Why do parks exist? They don't generate money.
Well, those are funded by the school.
Oh my God.
And by the people.
Okay, we are going in circles.
No. How much money is your radio show right now bringing to the table for this radio?
Yeah,
for
this radio why does this exist? Let's shut it down. It doesn't make any
shut
money.
It down, right?
Over $1,000 a year because I pay every single week for the show.
Okay.
And I don't ask anybody for money.
But I'm sure rowing could go.
Could use a little money for the show.
Be nice, wouldn't it?
Would be nice.
He's looking at me right now. I'm going to keep eye contact with Klonica, though.
We're good here. Keep your eyes on me. We're good.
I've never asked anybody for money for anything on this show. No. I always pay for
it. No, I just threaten to close the show every now and again and cancel and ruin your life. And then I bring it back. It's fine.
Yeah, no, but, okay, I'm sure the rowing team can go sell some Girl Scout cookies for $1,000. Yeah. I mean.
And then they all bring the money together, and then the troop gets to go on a nice little trip to the water park. I don't know what.
Wait,
the fuck
this show gets to go to the water park? Where the fuck have I been missing?
Yeah, we went to the water park. Fanarchy goes to the water park. Shit, he stays out of the pool.
But
he's just a sex.
That's why he was running from that rain earlier.
He's just like, water. I'm drowning. I can't swim. Can't swim.
Drowns in the rain.
All that makes the anniversary of the floods too. Remember today is the anniversary.
Jason
of that.
Walks out. I'm just on the ground like.
He's just, ow!
He's paddling in a puddle.
You just see bubbles.
He's got a fucking snorkel.
Geese, you're in quarter inch of water.
We come back and talk about Ursa next.
I'm not sure we should try and bring Osama bin Laden in by ourselves.
Steve, we don't have a choice. Now want to listen to us, and you got too drunk to tell the president.
What? It wasn't me who...
Get up with the past.
You're listening to... Are you sure you're okay to drive?
I will be after I hear the sobering wisdom of Miss Dolly Parton. Jolene, 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 Jolene. I'm begging of you, please don't take my man.
On caveradiobroadcasting.com.
But I understand why. See, it's burning me to hold on to this. I know this is something I gotta do. But that don't mean I want to. What I'm trying to say is that I love you. I feel like this is coming to an end, and it's better for me to let it go now.
We're back. Wilson did not make it. He slept in. He decided to sleep in. But we do have Klonica, and Tim is here.
Coming from somebody working midnight. Damn, that's a lot of sleep. Also, I wanted to give that shout out to Farouk.
Damn. Let's see. I had something else here. NFL news. Broncos starting defensive end Derek Wolfe hopes to be ready for week one after nasty sprained ankle. Funny story about Derek Wolfe. You ask anybody on the Broncos who's the one person nice to be trifled with,
the one person who's craziest, it is Derek Wolfe. Also, there was – remember the rumor a couple years ago when the Broncos won the Super Bowl and there was this controversy over someone saying that – telling Tom Brady that he would eat his kids on the field and Tom Brady got mad about that? It was Derek Wolfe. Finally, Usain Bolt breaks down in tears after pulling up injured in his final race of his career. I thought that was last week, but I guess that was his last 100. So, yeah. That was a bad way for Usain Bolt to go out. Being dominant for almost 10 years. Because he broke, well, 9 years. He broke on the scene at the 2008 Beijing Olympics. And now he's, you know, racing his final race. He also, his girlfriend also lets him cheat. Like crazy. And she doesn't mind it.
That feels like a message, too.
Message!
Okay. You were saying about we have an update on the Little League World Series coach.
You guys said it was Connecticut. This says SoCal.
Okay,
Little League coach gets suspended a game for cussing because you know the coaches are all mic'd up.
No, this was Connecticut, and it had to do with not playing somebody. I thought I could be wrong though. That was he might have been
okay,
doing a hypothetical.
Hold on. All right, because I'm looking it up. I was actually really curious on what the hell actually happened. So. But I did see that the coach from SoCal got suspended.
And they lost the game. I know Connecticut lost the game.
All right.
So
real quick.
Wow, Little League coaches ever again suspended.
No, man. They take this. Man, this stuff is. This is why I'm really, really worried about putting Ari in. Because he wants to play baseball next year. And I'm really worried. Because if he's not good, I don't want to have to fight some parent. Because he's taking it way too serious. And my kid's just out there trying to like let his fro run in the wind.
No, you just you got to make sure you
ask them first, hey, is this a very serious league or is this just like fun?
Well, there's a difference. Like, you're not signing your kid up for a $1,000 travel league.
No.
You're trying to let your kid play Little League where everyone gets to play.
But my kid's got an arm, man. He's got an arm and he can hit a little bit, man. I might have to go get coach Tim K. and give him some pointers.
Does he got an arm like Brucey in The Longest Yard?
He's
it's Brucey, sir.
He's got an arm, and I'm very proud of his arm. Also, I want to say shout out to Tim for pulling over and just helping random kids on the street with their baseball game. I was actually giving you a shout out for that.
No, I appreciate it. Hindsight 2020, that probably was a little creepy.
Yeah, I was thinking that
it
too, but I wasn't going to say that. But
no, it probably was a little creepy.
What's creepier, that or creeping on some homosexuals? Fucking.
No, listen. Listen.
All right. Yeah, let's listen to Keith's jack-off session on Thursday night.
I was
jerking off at these dudes who were fucking.
I was minding my own business. Actually, in South Lyon, Lyon Oaks Plaza.
Ooh, Lyon Oaks fucking.
On
why is everything out in the Northwest Detroit called, or Northwest Metro Detroit called something Oaks? 12 Oaks, West Oaks, no fucking.
Well, this is the name of the plaza that I was
in. I know, all the plazas out there are something Oaks. Is there a lot of oak trees out there in Novi and South Lyon? I don't know.
Now, I won't lie if I say every time I go into a parking lot and I see a random car sitting in the middle of in a dark corner in the parking lot.
Jerking off.
No, I go by there purposely to see if there's some kind of nefarious activity going on.
It made me think of a story from my youth, but go ahead.
One time I saw someone getting roadhead on the at a stoplight.
So I jumped in and we fucking Eiffel Towered
I thought it was pretty good. And I was like, all right, you know, that's pretty dope. But I pulled into the – I pulled – what, you got something?
Yeah, I'm reading this story. This is fucking fantastic.
Is it the Connecticut thing?
Yeah. Go ahead. You finish and I'll
– finish all over this story.
So I pull in. There's –
they pull out.
They were in a corner. They were in a corner. And so, you know, I see two cars next to each other in the corner. And I'm like, oh, you know, because a lot of times, you know, look.
That's a drug deal.
You'll be surprised about a couple things. All right, that happens in parking lots at night. One, the amount of people who sleep in their cars. Mm-hmm. They'll be in nice cars, and they'll just be sleeping in it.
Mm-hmm.
Or people that are in, you know, regular-ass cars, and they're sleeping in their cars because they don't have a home. That's very disheartening. I see it all the time at the 7 and Middle Belt Walmart. There's this guy
that. Well, that's the trailer park of the trailer park of Livonia.
The guy. Right there. Well, there's a guy that sleeps in a silver Grand Prix every night. Sleeps in it.
Shout out to my mans.
Shout out to him. Hopefully you get somewhere better to sleep.
And jack off.
You will also be very surprised at how many people at 1 in the morning decide to go into a Kroger parking lot to work out their relationship issues.
With their genitals?
No. Like, you'll see them, like, I'll pass by them a few times, and you'll see one girl with her hand in her head, you know, almost like, what the fuck, and a guy just, like, pointing at her and yelling, or the other way around where the girl is pointing.
That's the relationship fight grocery shopping trip, like, where you're like, fine, you want to go grocery shopping, bitch? Fine, let's go right the fuck now. We'll go to Kroger at 1 in the fucking morning. And then they get in the parking lot. He's like, are you happy? We're at the fucking Kroger at 1 in the morning. I got to work at 6 a.m. so we can buy the fucking groceries, but you want to buy them right now instead of letting me sleep. So get out of the car. Quit your crying, bitch. Quit your crying. I don't know why you're crying right now. There's a fucking street sweeper staring at us, jerking off. I don't know what the fuck you're doing. We got to fucking go. You want this? Do you want him to finish? Do you want him to finish?
Hey, finish so we can go inside and go shopping. I want to go shopping so I go to bed.
In the MLB news, breaking news, Mets close to trading second baseman Neil Walker to the Brewers. Wow, he already played for the Brewers.
No, he didn't. He did not. He played for the Pirates.
He played for the Pirates. No, okay. I had him 1 year, the 1 year I played fantasy baseball and won. And, no, but you'll.
That's
but
cute.
So you'll be surprised at how many people really like, or how
you
many
so
times.
Mean. Why are you doing this? To
how
me?
Many times you find out that coworkers are fucking because they're arguing in the parking lot and then have to go back after their break?
Why you have to tell Tim?
You know. So, but I pull into this lot and I see two cars off in the corner and I'm like, oh well, maybe you know they're just leaving it there overnight or whatever. And all of a sudden, I see skin and I see butt up against the window and I'm like, that's booty.
Cut to his dick, and he goes, hey.
Right?
Just a little move. Hey.
So for a second, I'm like, oh. Hey. So I pull up, and all of a sudden, I see the butt move, and I see, like, hands and stuff going up against the window. And I just pass by as if I don't see him, so I have my hood on because I keep the AC on in my truck.
He has his hood on, so they can't see him. Never mind, he's in this fucking loud-ass truck.
Let's ignore the fact that what they see is a Jedi driving a fucking street sweeper.
I already saw
one hand on his dick. She's like, what is that?
I already have my hood on because I keep the AC on and it blows in my face and I don't like AC blowing in my face, but I like the feeling of AC. Okay. So I pull up and they're like this.
Right? Yeah, right.
So I don't know that this is two dudes. I just think that this is, you know, a guy and a girl trying to have sex.
Oh, he got caught with his hand on his penis with two dudes.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
Oh, no.
Like, he definitely was like, no!
So I pull around it the first time, and I'm like, oh, they fucking. So now I'm trying to plot on how I can kind of, like, watch this.
Told you! There it is!
You know, maybe get on my phone, take a little video for, you know, when I get home.
I want to jerk off to some gay porn.
So what I did was I pulled around to the other side of the building, and I sat there for, like, 5 minutes, packed a bowl, and was sitting there. So, you know, they could get back fucking thinking I left.
He's gone.
So I pulled back on him.
Get back to work, James.
So I pull up and the same thing happens. And I'm like, okay, now you're just kind of being an asshole because, you know, you're messing up this guy's poor nut. And, you know, I have been
these
in
these guys' poor nut.
Did not know it was two guys yet, though.
Oh, hey, okay. What's his saying? If you can dream about it, there's porn about it. Street sweeper watching gay porn.
That's my tagline.
MM4SS.
Motherless.com. Check it out.
So
Mayo Mail for street sweeper. So...
somehow this is going to turn into a trilogy and somehow Keys is going to join.
So
street sweeper catches two dirty men,
stands, you know, in the middle holding a double-sided dildo. Just
I go and, you know, I do look, this isn't a parking lot that's very dirty. So
well,
I go
now
and,
it is.
Now it is.
I go and I do my job. Yeah, and I know it's real dirty too. So I go.
And that's how they finish.
I go and I finish cleaning up or whatever. I try to get out of there as quick as possible because I'm like, all right, I feel bad, but maybe I could see a titty or something.
Important question: who won the race? Did they finish first or you finish first?
I did because it wasn't that dirty of a. Shut up.
Yeah, that makes sense. You always finish first.
So
Jolene.
So I go. So my next stop was literally across the street. So I go across the street and clean that lot or whatever. And then I'm like,
All I could think about was catching these two people fucking, and I want to see what the girl looks like or whatever. I'm really intrigued by this. And they were like teenagers. They were like teenagers. So
oh, they were newly gay.
Yeah, they're baby gays.
Yeah, so they were like little twinkies. They were little twinks. But that's not,
actually the proper term.
So I go do that lot. I take about 10 minutes in that lot, and then I come back just to see, just to, you know, whatever, just to come back, and I see it's like this dude, and he's got like blonde hair, and it's all like poofed up into the side, and he's got on the gay
Bailey,
the gay boy glasses.
Bailey,
he has on the gay boy frame glasses, and it's another dude who has on like these plaid shorts and a t-shirt, and you could tell he probably did not want people to know he was gay, and I'm like, whoa, it's two dudes, woo, woo, and at that time. Like, this is like 1 in the morning.
He's wishing he's trying to, like, shove cum back in.
This is like, no! I can't believe I can't believe I came to this.
It already dried. Can I shove the powder in? What do I got to do?
And so I'm like,
I know one thing I got to do. Not talk about this on Saturday.
I'm like, you know, I forgot all about this until you brought it up. I also, someone yesterday filmed me doing my job, and I wanted to get
That's
out.
That's weird.
Yeah, like she was sitting there with her phone and she was following me like this and taking pictures.
How is it any more fucking weird than you driving around the gay dudes in a fucking car trying to video them?
Because I did not know that it was two gay dudes at the
it
time.
It doesn't matter. You were still
it
trying.
It doesn't matter what you jerk off.
I thought I was getting some regular underage teen porn. Like, I don't know.
And we all know how he feels about underage girls. How about that?
Yes. Yes.
So I did this once, so, and it turned into a heterosexual couple. When I was fucking 19, there's a park in Dearborn Heights called Playscape or Silver Lane Park, depending on who you talk to. And we used to, like, I used to think it was funny to try to get in chases where I was being chased. So I would try to piss people off so they would chase me.
Why in the fuck? Looking at you now, why the fuck would you do that?
Well, that's why I drive a motorcycle and an SVT Focus. I like to be able to evade. I don't know. I like to know that I can get away. And then if they catch up to me, I get out and they're like, oh shit, never mind. That's a big fucking guy. I'm not gonna fuck with him. But no, so there was this couple, or there was a car with fogged up like Titanic style fog windows and like a handprint on the side too. And I'm like,
straight from the scene.
Yeah, and I'm with two friends and they're like, you know what we gotta do? And I'm like, yeah, I do. So we just start. So the car is up against the corner of the parking lot, and we just start driving in circles, flashing brights and honking a horn. Just honk, 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 honk. Until they finally, you see the dude start like pulling his shirt on and like crawling over the seat, and he gets into the front seat, and they start backing out. We start like, I'm like, okay, cool, time to go, and we start running away, and they chased us half a block and went back. They started fucking again. So we came back just... Did it three more times and they finally started chasing us and like took like a 20-minute chase. They finally cornered me and they're like, what the fuck? What the fuck? I'm like, I don't know. Sorry. I got out and they're just like, never mind. They just left because it was like some scrawny little dude just like you were talking about. Like, oh... Oh, you're a lot bigger than I anticipated.
Well, because there was last night there was a girl, like I said, was filming me doing my job, and I didn't know why.
If there's a porn like, about it, if you can dream about it, there's a porn about it.
And so I was gonna get so I'm getting pissed off because like I don't know why she's just taking pictures of me or but like if you see someone taking random pictures of you while you're doing
where
your
were
job,
you?
I was actually at Bush's grocery store in Pickney.
Oh, that's well, why she just, probably never saw,
they never
black
saw
person.
A black person.
again, I always have my hood on because I have my AC on.
So they never saw a black Jedi.
Well, listen.
Have you ever seen a black Jedi besides Mace Windu?
You didn't have a watermelon drink, did you? You had a hood up and a watermelon drink.
Big-ass lemonade.
There you go,
yep.
Boom.
Like, I guess all I needed was some Skittles.
Did you
huh?
need Skittles?
Yep. Fuck, now I get it. And I was going to get
you
out
understand.
The car.
We're living stereotype.
Well, I was going to get out the car because I was going to get out the car and be like, what the fuck are you doing? But then I also noticed that she had her phone up, and the last thing you need is angry black guy who really isn't angry black guy who's been said by the friend of the court is an angry black guy. So I'm keeping all of this in mind because I don't need this to be viral of me getting out of the car.
So I'm driving around.
Her, what
oh,
the
so
fuck are you
that
doing?
To be viral.
So I'm driving around sending text messages.
Because I really wanted to get out of my car. Like, what the fuck are you doing? Like, filming me doing my job.
And she's like, watch, he's going to get out the car.
And I wanted to, I really, really wanted to do that. And I was like, I can't be on YouTube you know, yelling at this lady in Pickney, what the fuck are you doing?
The day before a white power rally.
During basically what was the white rally, the white power
the
rally.
Power to restore white sanity.
Oh my God.
The rally to like, restore white power.
Real quick to update that Connecticut thing before we forget about it. He took the suspension. So he knew he didn't bat the kid. They were down by one. It was 7-6. They were down. So he was like, yeah, I'm not fucking hitting this kid who can't hit. You guys go up there. You fucking go hit. Go win the game. I'll take the 2-game suspension. Meanwhile, poor little fucking what's-his-face is over there in the corner like, I didn't get to play in the Little League World Series. My parents just paid how much money for me to be here?
Oh, no.
So, yeah, that's what happened. He had a chance to win the game. They still advance. There's no rule that says they lose automatically if he doesn't play everyone. Mm. He takes a 2-game suspension. So in order to give his team the best shot to win, he was willing to take that 2-game suspension.
Had he play?
I can't say I wouldn't have done the same thing. Listen, 2 outs. Lex is coming to the plate. Or I got to put in little Sophia over there. Lex is fucking hitting.
I have a feeling he had a player named Sophia who couldn't play.
I was just going to say, Sophia's a real person. She's like, I just the mean man hate me.
No, I had to think about it, too, before I said a name. I didn't want to say any team girl names that happened to be on teams that she may have played on or play on now.
So white power.
How about we come back with that?
Okay.
No, don't do it.
I also am waiting because I know that this is going to happen. I'm waiting for the Cash Me Outside girl to have nudes leak.
How about that?
She's 13.
She's 13.
Oh!
Yeah.
Oh!
Yeah, I was just going to say.
Oh!
CaveRadioBroadcasting.com.
Electroconvulsive Therapy, Part 1.
This is Endo, produced by Timbo. Game over. Nah, the NWA chain chokers. Burn a rubber inside the Range Rover.
We thank Mark Miles for coming on with us today. Make sure you check out his new song, On My Way to the Top. Thanks to Tim Klonica for coming in and hanging out. It's always good when it's a surprise and he comes and hangs out with us because he just shows the fuck up.
I do.
And
sometimes
I appreciate it.
Sometimes I get worried, like, what if there's no show since you guys decide you don't want to have shows like five times a year?
Oh, God damn, man. We
cancel the show like twice a week.
He had to drink his lemonade.
I like when Klonica comes in because it's someone else to help me deal with Keith.
Looking like Ursher.
He's got the beats to make your booty go.
You got the clap.
Well,
too
fat to slap anymore.
So in Charlottesville...
It's just a fat hand.
In Charlottesville, there's a protest going on, and it's over the removal of a Confederate statue. They are damn near rioting. They rioted in the streets. With their tiki torches.
I sounded like Klonica there for a second.
with
their tiki torches.
From Walmart that are made in China.
Yep.
The one thing I did notice.
Those were American tiki torches. They showed the tag.
The one thing I did notice was there was no cops to be found in riot gear. Wondering how come that was.
There's the other racist aspect of this. The cops are like, yeah, they're tailing them.
I just saw a picture on Facebook.
Also, you're not supposed. Yeah,
they were chanting. Some of the chants they were saying was in immigration.
Yeah,
you will not.
Jew go home.
You will not replace us. Which I don't know what they mean by you will not.
Jew will not replace us. Because they perceive that every time we allow a new culture, and I'm putting finger quotes up for the listener.
They just don't want them taking the jobs, man. That's all.
That's not it at all.
Okay, yeah. Yeah, no one's... Yeah, because the Indian that comes over here and is a doctor
Listen,
is taking
away. I need you to not say things when I say things like that, because I'm baiting him.
I know, I forget. I'm sorry.
It's so much fun watching
him
get
the other aspect of this, too, is they forget. Like, they want everybody to go home and not take our jobs. As they do on South Park. But there's also like a problem right now in California where crops are just rotting because because all the Mexicans have been kicked out. And they're like we're losing whole crops of food just because nobody wants to pick it. Because the white people won't stop doing white, quote-unquote, white people jobs to lower themselves to a Mexican job. They're too busy bitching about how we have no jobs, you fucking retards.
This
country's going to hell very quickly.
So has anyone called them? I mean, I've been on social media, but I haven't seen. Has anyone been calling them thugs yet? Has anyone told them that they need to find a job?
Oh, the white people?
Yeah.
No, but there is one difference that from like a black protest, which is where you're trying to go with this. Like a black protest would have ended with police brutality. The students in this case just started beating the shit out of them. Did you see that?
Out of who?
Out of the white guys. You didn't see that at the end of that rally?
No.
They got to a statue at the base of the statue of Thomas Jefferson, and a bunch of college students that were there just like, come on, let's go.
Bring
and then
it
they
on.
Just fucking ran at each other like in a Twilight movie at the end. Or fucking Avengers Civil War. Like fucking just two lines running at
each
other.
It looked like Game of Thrones.
Yeah, yeah. Well, I was trying to go gayer because it was a stupid, frivolous fight.
Okay.
Game of Thrones actually has like a reason usually.
Well, you know what it reminded me of? When I look at the pictures, it reminded me of the Simpsons movie when they were all going after Homer with their tiki torches.
Mm-hmm. It was reminding me of. But this, they didn't show, like, it didn't get much media coverage, but I've seen a bunch of videos of it. Like, they literally didn't expect the college students to be there. Like, they got there and just like, white power is, oh, shit.
What the fuck are you guys doing
and
here?
And you're like, well, then let's go.
Like, ah, come on.
And you just see them beating the fuck out of each other. And those white guys fight like fucking sneaky motherfuckers. Like, there's one white dude in, like, he's in the center photo of that one picture that's being going around.
Yeah.
He's in, like, a button-down shirt that's, like, gray or white or something, I think, or maybe,
like
light blue.
He dressed in this fucking rioting vest.
Yeah. And that dude in the fight is, like, he's, like, hanging back. He's like, all right. And then, like, he's punching over a bigger guy, and, like, in that little girly punch where his wrist goes limp, I'm like, that's like, he's, like, working heel in wrestling. That's what you would do. You put fucking Baron Corbin out there, and then you hang out behind him. He's go, eh. Like, he's fucking working heel.
They were wearing...
He's
some
getting
of,
heat.
Yeah.
Some of them...
He got heat from me. It worked. I was like, boo! Wait, what am I doing?
You suck.
You suck. Da-da.
You suck.
Da-da.
You suck.
Da-da.
So, So... The Red Wings
John
got
Cena sucks. The, White Power sucks.
The Red Wings got the Detroit Red Wings got wrapped in this because it is a Red Wing that is going to the right, and they have
the Red Wing
out.
Logo, yeah.
And they said we're no. Let's
they
be
made
real.
An official
some
page that said we are the Right Wings.
We will say that some of our fans are racist, but we ain't got nothing to do with this.
Mm-hmm.
So. It's just
good save.
And then the car comes out of nowhere. Like,
yeah, someone hit him with a car. Remember when they were protesting for? Remember when people were protesting for Black Lives Matter? And then someone ran a car, and everyone was like, "Good!" And now they run into it, and they're like, "You shouldn't do this. They're protesting." it's like,
and where's Tommy Lahren about this one? Like,
where is Tommy Lahren?
Why aren't we? Did you guys see the president and the vice president's post about it? They're all like vague.
No, Tamika Lahren's on this one.
Yeah, right. Tamika Lorenzo. Yeah.
Yeah.
Tamika Lorenzo.
Yeah. Somehow, I bet you LeVar Ball comes out of somewhere and has something to say about that.
They're undefeated. They never lost. Except for when they got pushed to the face by all those college dudes. No, but I lost my train of thought. It's gone.
Wow. Shout out to Big Baller Brand. They're going to be in the new 2K game.
Cool.
They're going to have the Big Baller shoes in the...
They
the,
got pixelated avatars of their shoes made.
Wow.
Listen, man. For all the shit people talked about this guy, he's making shit happen.
It's true.
Bottom line, he's making shit happen.
He did it.
He's making money.
Oh, yeah, the president and the vice president's post about it where they were just like, we must unite against evil. Like, they weren't really saying, like, this is wrong.
Yeah, yeah.
And then they hashtag Charlottesville, and I'm like, what? Like, the, huh?
Well, also, this is the
same. He wanted to say something without saying something.
Yeah, they wanted to say we support this shit. This is what it is.
This is the same president that went up there and basically told the New York, the people, the officers of New York, if you got to be a little rough with people, be rough with them.
You see these towns, and when you see these thugs being thrown into the back of a paddy wagon, you just see them thrown in, rough. I said, please don't be too nice. Like when you guys put somebody in the car and you're protecting their head, you know, the way you put their hand over. like, don't hit their head, and they've just killed somebody, don't hit their head. I said, you can take the hand away, okay?
Yeah, that was dumb.
Very.
But when does he go a day without doing something really fucking stupid?
Well, I mean, we didn't get to talk much Trump in the last couple of weeks, but I think Sarah Huckabee is very, very sexy.
more things Keith jerks off to.
I do.
Press coverage.
I do. That, she is
he's watching MSNBC.
She is such a bitch, and I find it so sexy because she is such a bitch.
That's the one. I like that that's the one you don't turn against. You're like, I do. Yes, absolutely, 100%.
No, remember, I love Sean Spicer. Remember, I told you guys I wanted Sean Spicer. You jerked up to him, too.
Well, now that we know his new gay porn fetish.
Yeah, right?
I was.
Only if it's live action.
Yo, I texted my girl, and I was like, I saw two gay dudes fucking. I'm kind of turned on.
I saw like two gays do fucking, and then there's like, she doesn't respond, and like 15 minutes later, it moved, period. She's like, no!
I was like,
it moved, I'm sorry.
It wasn't the fact it was gay sex, it was just sex in general. I'm like, wow, you guys are getting laid, and I'm not. I want to get laid now.
Yep. That's exactly the way you want to end a show with you talking about how gay sex makes you want to say anything about
those MLB unis real quick? Because I know you want.
Oh, yeah, the MLB uni thing.
Wow, way to bring it all around.
I think that's actually, I think it's kind of cool. And it actually got to Lex because Lex saw him or whatever. And she was like, Dad, she's like, I want a jersey with my nickname on the back. I'm like, well, I don't know how the fuck we're going to do that. So shout out to D.O. over in Dearborn because they are getting her a jersey that says Beast Mode on the back with her number instead of her last name.
What is what's Harper's? What's Bryce Harper's going to be?
His says Big Kid, which I'm really shocked about. I know that's what a lot of people in the locker room called it, but I thought for sure it'd be Bam Bam because that's what it was through high school and college.
I am surprised that you haven't sent that to Bryce Harper and been like, here, you trademark it, then send it to Bryce Harper.
No.
And be like, yo, you could use this.
What would your guys' jersey name nickname be?
Mine would probably say Keith, K-Y-S, K-Y-S.
It would 100% be MegaKlon.
Yeah, of course.
Mine would be Fat-Ass.
It'd be MegaKlon, 100%.
I would, man, come on. It would be great, the pink Hambino. Like, I still love that.
Did you see Travis Darnot's Little D? Like, how are they allowing that? I cannot believe. That jersey is going to be the number one nickname selling jersey out there.
Well, I thought if it was Big D, then yeah. But like, no one wants to go around with Little D on their back.
Well, according to Keese, I have a Little D, so I should probably get that jersey.
You probably
peel
should.
Over my stomach.
Get a Little D jersey in a 4X.
Yep. And then just peel over my stomach. Now, baseball jerseys, do they size like hockey where it's like one.
They're
two,
very
three.
Long.
Right, no,
they're
but
very
like,
long.
Have you ever seen the jump between a 2X and a 3XL hockey jersey?
Yeah,
it's like a fucking jersey.
It's a
and
twin
then a
size to a queen size.
Yeah, it's like a fucking single to a queen. It's like, it's so big. Like the I wear a 2XL hockey jersey, and I didn't even know they made above 2XL, and I think I told this story before. And I was at what's it called?
Fanarchy-Two,
and like I went over to the like plus size section. I was like, oh hey, it's 3XL.
He's at the plus size section like he was shopping at Fashion Bug or something.
He's got to fold.
That's what they called it.
He's got to fold his shirts like a big comforter.
That's what I was really confused about the size jump. It was like 2X to 3X was like a shirt to a tarp. It was a rubber band to a tire. Like that much of a size difference. Like what the fuck is this?
Over under fair. He's on it. Jason, he shouts, thank yous, fuck yous, or apologies.
Shout out.
Damn, you're normally on these.
No, I got nothing this week. It's been kind of a meh week.
Okay.
Yeah, sorry. I'm kind of a letdown here.
MegaKlon, at your local baseball diamond being creepy with your kid.
Wow.
Pulling over to help you, being creepy, helping your kid play baseball. You want
scouting
me to throw,
your children.
Want me to throw some balls at you?
How about that?
He's there. Tim, any shout-outs, thank yous, fuck yous, or apologies?
Throwing his balls at your children.
Shout-out to all my friends and family for dealing with me for the last 2 months. I know it hasn't been easy just because all the shit that's going on between softball and softball. So I appreciate you guys hanging tight with me and not killing me because I probably would have killed someone if they were like me.
How much would the ratio be to how much Marissa loves baseball as opposed to how much
Marissa loves watching Lex play softball?
Marissa could give a fuck less about any other kids. Like, she loves watching Lex because Lex makes her happy. Whereas, like, I have to help every individual kid or I feel like I'm not doing my job in life. So I seriously will help any kid. No, it's not creepy. But
we're kidding about that. It's
the coach in me. But
once it crosses into sincere, we stop joking.
Yeah, no, there's a difference between my love for the softball game and Marissa's.
I'm really once the court deems me fit to be a parent.
So in 2028.
In 2028, I'm going to bring my kid to you so he can learn some for real, some baseball.
When he's 19 years old.
Yeah. Fuck you to
the hard work.
No. Fuck you to all those parents who walked away from our team because they wanted to chase the name on the front of the jersey instead of
the name on the back.
Instead of chasing what's good for their child. I think parents nowadays really need a reality check on the talent of their kid because everyone's kid isn't as great as other kids. And I think parents really need to realize that before they start making decisions based on that, because coaches lie.
That's a roundabout way to say, look, don't be mad because my kid's better than all your kids.
Good players chase jerseys. Great players make jerseys. That's the bottom line.
You come with the best sports cliche.
So that's why she's staying put, and we're gonna win where we're at.
I do have one shout out to Sprite Cherry.
Yeah,
I enjoy it immensely. I'm glad they made
Tropical Mixed Sprite is also good.
That's the truth.
And I have two of them in the car as
well. Nice.
And then thank you to Marissa. Thank you for being there for these last 2 months.
Shout out, Marissa. And thanks for letting us borrow one.
Yeah, and dealing with softball talk 24/7. We talk 3 times a day.
This is first on the day phone. Off, he left.
Yeah. three times a day on the phone, and I swear to God, all 3 times that we talk on the phone, it's softball, what happened at softball practice, and what's going to happen at softball practice. And it's really bad. We really don't talk about anything other than that. So thank you, babe. Love you.
When you get it in real good at night, do you consider it a grand slam? Like, do you judge your sex performance?
Oh, no.
Based off of that, you'd be like, baby, I'm sorry. It was a strikeout today. I went 0-5.
No. I run in the room with a softball chance. Like, I'm fired up. You fired up? Yeah.
Yeah.
I see a hole out there. I see an H-O-L-E hole out there. And so, you know, that is a real fucking softball chant. That is a real softball chant. And I can't get it out of my head. So, yeah, it definitely shouldn't be used by little girls.
Marissa, now ever. I just imagine you doing that rugby thing, though, where it's like a bunch of fucking Samoans just...
Oh, the chant. Yeah.
Like he's just Marissa, hitting himself with shit.
Marissa naturally looks like she hates everybody, but I imagine if you come into that... Come into the bedroom with that, she's just going to turn over and say she has a headache.
I don't have to go in there with that first. Turn over and say she has a headache. 90% of the time, it's, why don't you go sleep in Lex's room?
Here's the laptop. Go.
No, there's none of that. It's well, why don't you go sleep in Lex's room?
I can't take care of this. What the fuck?
No, Lex thinks it's the greatest thing ever, dude. We don't even sleep in the same bed anymore. Lex sleeps in the bed. I'll sleep on the floor in a room, and we'll fall asleep watching whatever's on MLB Network. It's the greatest thing ever.
I wish I was half as good father as you. Shout out to the...
Man, I'm glad I don't have any kids.
Shout out to the gay sex...
I'm going to go get drunk.
Shout out to...
Oh, I'm going to do that as well.
Shout out to the gay sex that I saw the other night. Also,
jerked off to.
Shout out to the couple whose wedding we crashed. Really, for real, because that was fun.
You said it was Belle Isle, right?
Yeah, it was at Belle Isle. Me and her.
Why do black people get married on Belle Isle? I saw two of those last time I went there.
No, it was black people.
That's what I said. Okay. Why do black people get married on
Belle Isle? White people go to Belle Isle just to take their wedding pictures.
Yeah, why do black people get married on Belle Isle?
Because it's a question. Well, I'm going to tell you how it happened. Because today's her birthday, and so I took her out yesterday for her birthday, and we went to Belle Isle, got on Giant Slide, went to the aquarium. And
I did the aquarium a couple weeks ago. It's great.
And we went to the fountain. Of course, we went to the fountain, of course. And we just see people like with chairs just lined up, and then one guy in an all white suit. And we're
that's over by the observatory.
Yeah. And so
that's where we saw
him. To the big fountain.
Yeah.
And so
it's like a big courtyard.
And so there was like things. There was questions I had. I like did like was it in the invitation that everyone bring a chair, bring a folding chair out? Because it seemed like this was really like pop up type shit. And we sat there, and I'm like, wow, these dudes are getting married. Like, these girls are, like, well, these two people are getting married, and, you know, the wife was pregnant, more so that explains a lot more. And, you know, they had...
When I say shotgun, you say wedding.
They had, you know, and shotgun. And, like, we felt bad that we were in all of their pictures, so we actually moved to the other side of the fountain, found a shady spot, and then sat there, watched this wedding, and then when they kissed and was officially introduced, we actually, like, stood up and, like, applauded them. They're probably looking at us like...
Meanwhile, Keith is like, that's the closest you're getting to a wedding.
I apologize
if that may cost you at home at all. Sorry.
Yeah, no, it ain't going to cost me at all.
My friend, when I went and we saw the wedding there, she saw that wedding and she was like, I would never do that. I'm like, what? She's like, an outdoor, like, halfway destination wedding? Like, you're not quite committing to an actual destination?
It's actually really cheap because all they got to do is just go out there, get it done real quick, and then leave.
Better hope it doesn't rain.
Well, it didn't rain, so good for them, man. Let's see. You can catch us on iTunes. You can catch us on Podbean. You can catch us right here live every Saturday from 4 to 6-ish. Remember, if you're into it, there's probably porn for it, and you can probably find it on motherless.com. And stop making black dudes wear condoms in interracial scenes. What?
And for the podcast listeners, we are live every Saturday on crbradio.com. We need you guys to start fucking paying attention to that and start doing more downloading, less streaming.
Yeah, download us.
We used also to be, on you guys used to make us top 10 every fucking week. We need that shit back.
Yeah.
Do it again. Yeah. That's my call out for the week. The listener. Fucking get on it with the downloads. Tell your friends about us.
PBJ, happy birthday, girl. Happy birthday. Hope you have a good one. All right, Donovan, thank you for letting me dream for one more week. I think that we are done.
Later, haters. Bye, people. I could pee on that.
Mayor! All right, we'll talk to you guys. You got anything to say?
No, I'm good, man.
Baseball is life. All right, we will talk to you guys next week.